Good morning, students. Today's topic is the novel The Call of the Wild. About the author, it was written by Jack London. He was a very interesting person. He was born in San Francisco on January 12th. 1876. He grew up in poverty and was a juvenile delinquent, a young person who is guilty of committing a crime. In his late teens, he traveled US through as a hobo, means a homeless person, on freight trains, that is good trains. At the age of 21, he moved north to the Klondike territory in search of gold. Although he did not make any money from his time spent in Alaska searching for gold, his adventures gave him many stories, including The Call of the Wild. He died on November 22nd, 1916, at the age of 40. About the book, it is said, The Call of the Wild takes place at the time gold was being discovered in the Yukon region of Canada, called the Klondike Gold Rush. Now coming toward the next major characters of this novel, the first one is Buck, a 140-pound half Saint Bernard, half Scotch Shepherd mix. John Thornton, an experienced gold miner. Judge Miller, Buck's original owner. Then comes Dave, a member of Buck's dog sledge team, teacher to Buck. Spitz is ruthless, means cruel and cunning animal who can do anything to preserve his power. Perrault, a French-Canadian male driver. He is Francois' sledging partner. Mercedes, Hal's sister, and Charles' wife. Curly, a friendly she-dog whom Buck befriends early in her life. Solex, a one-eyed dog. Other team dogs were Billy and Joe, Deep and Una, Skeet and Nick, Manuel. He was a gardener at Judge Miller's Santa Clara State. He kidnaps and sells Buck to an unknown dog trader. The Yahats, the tribes of Indians that murdered Thornton.
We just discussed about the author, the book, then the different characters of this novel. Now, coming to the first chapter of this novel, Into the Primitive. Primitive means early stages, you can say, or ancient times. Well, the trouble brewing where? In California. Trouble brewing in California. Gold had been discovered in Arctic regions, and a gold rush. Gold rush. When we come to say gold rush. Gold rush. For what? Gold rush for yellow metal. Yellow metal. Gold rush for yellow metal. The very first word I said, trouble brewing. Trouble brewing means trouble brewing means bad situation. Bad situation. So, trouble brewing in California, gold had been discovered in the Arctic regions, and a gold rush, yellow metal, was on. It was on. Men were looking for straw dogs to toil. Men for toil. Toil means to work very hard. Toil. To work very hard. Looking for to work very hard endlessly and to withstand the severe cold. Buck lived in a what house, student? Buck lived in a very big house. And whose house? That was Judge Miller's place. Where was it? It was in Santa Clara Valley. The house was large and spacious. It was very spacious. It was huge. It was very spacious. It had a wide, it had a wide lawns, and even more spacious it was at the back also, and it had beautiful gardens were in front of the house. It had a beautiful gardens. It was Buck's kingdom. Basically, whose kingdom? Whose kingdom? It was Buck's kingdom. Buck's kingdom, to which he had been born and ruled for 4 years of his life. For 4 years of his life, he spent there. Buck was special and was different. He was totally different to the pampered house dog like Toots and Isabel. By like whom? Toots and Isabel. He was neither a house dog nor a kennel dog, but he used to move wherever he wished. So he was free to do. He was not asked to, yes, you have to go. He was very much free. Not only that, student, he was courted by Judge Miller's. He escorted Judge Miller's daughter on walk, hunted with his sons, used to spend the wintry nights at the judge's feet in front of the library fire. And Manuel was a Manuel. Who was Manuel? Coming to who was Manuel? Who was Manuel? Who was Manuel? Who was Manuel? Manuel. Manuel was a gardener's helper and amassed, it is said, amassed, that is to gather together or accumulate a large amount or number of materials or things over a period of time. So a gardener's helper, you can say, a gardener's one who helped. So Manuel, he was a gardener's helper. So what he did, he was in debt. And what he did, he was in debt. Why was he in debt? Because he used to gamble. Basically, he was into use of gambling. So that he used to do is, so his salary can barely support his large family. And he had a very large family. So it was not possible that with that little of amount, he could fulfill his family and he could take care of his family. And there was little left to help him. So one night when Judge Miller and was out of his house and his sons had gone, then Manuel takes an unsuspecting buck. He just takes a buck to walk into the orchards. He takes him away and then they arrive at the, where do they arrive? After that, what he does, you know, he takes him to the flag station where a man was waiting for them. Then money changes there. What happens? He just changes, means just exchange, means he's going to hand it over buck to an unknown person. So here money changes hands and Manuel tied a strong rope around whose neck? Around buck's neck. So he was tied a strong rope and he was holding it and then he was going to hand it over. When the stranger tries to take that rope, when the stranger to whom he was handed over, so tries the rope, buck, what happens? He growls. Growls means what? Growls means to make a low and guttural sound in the throat. Because the animal, you see, when they make sound, especially if you are talking about a dog, so that sound he does, buck growls and the rope tightens. The rope tightens, cutting off his throat. And he flies violently at the man. What he does? He flies violently, very cruelly at the man. And he just tries to run and only to be choked repeatedly. Despite his fury. Fury means wild. Fury. You see, fury. Wild or violent or violent. Violent anger. Violent anger. Buck was thrown into the baggage car of the train. After that he was thrown, he was taken, he was choked, his throat got choked, then he was thrown into the baggage of the train. He had another struggle. What was that struggle with the man? Biting his hands quite badly. He was very badly. What did he do? Yes, of course, he was. If somebody does, of course, what we do? If somebody tries to attack, so this is what Buck also did. he wanted that if he was being harmed or he was being beaten or he was his throat was being choked, so what he did, he started biting his hand. And after that, the man tells the conductor that Buck is being taken. Where was then? The man says, yes, Buck is being taken to San Francisco in order to cure his fits. And where means fits means he was getting a sort of a seizure, he was getting it. So he was being taken to Francisco. And later that night, the kidnapper complained about the job to a saloon keeper. And saloon keeper means, what is the meaning of saloon keeper? Meaning means where you just go and have it, the saloons for your hair cut, you go. So that's where he was. That was about saloon keeper insisting that he wouldn't do it again for $1,000, much less than the 50 that he was paid. Buck was fitted with a brass collar. He was given that brass collar and thrown it into the cage. He said that it should be thrown into cage. And throughout that night, he just wondered. Once he was in doubt. Wonder means he was in doubt. Wondered, in doubt. He was in doubt. He wondered. He just continuously thought, and that he wondered. That why he was there, what was the reason that he was there, what he did, you know, he was just thinking that what he had done, that he was there. And then his pride was wounded and he wanted the judge to come for him. And that time, you know, student, what happened, he was thinking about whom? About the Judge Miller. That time he was thinking about the Judge Miller. The cage was switched to an express, the express train. It was just given for the express train that would reach to Seattle in 2 days. And it would take how many days? It would take 2 days to reach to Seattle. So occasionally, what happens, Buck was harassed. And in between, when he was there, he was purposely, you know, he was harassed. That was mentally harassed, mentally tortured. He was harassed and he was mentally tortured. He was mentally harassed. Harassed means mentally. He was mentally tortured. Okay? Is it clear? He was mentally tortured. By men. By whom? He was tortured by whom? By men who poke sticks. And what they used to do? They used to poke it with sticks and at him through his cage where he was taken. So he was given nothing. Not only he was mentally or physically tortured, but what was that? He was given nothing to eat or to drink. And that discomfort, and his discomfort only augments, means increased, augments his wrath. Augments his wrath. Augments his wrath. Augments his wrath. And augments his wrath means to increase his anger. Of course, if somebody does it, what one will happen to you? You know, somebody keeps on poking or somebody keeps on doing something. What happens? Irritating, sometimes getting, always getting beating or scolding something. What happens? That it increases. So this is what it happened with Buck 2. This also happened. So then he vows. What he promised? He vows that he never to let any rope be placed upon him. Then he promised, vows, that not a single rope will be placed upon him. When the train was uploaded, a man in a red sweater approaches. What's the meaning of approaches? Approaches means to come near. To approaches, 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 to come nearer, so come near. So he just approaches that the crate as four other men look on. Then what happens? The man carried a hatchet, means an axe.
H-A-T-C-H-E-T.
What's the meaning of this? An axe with a light short handle. An axe with a light short handle. Okay, it is light with a short handle. An axe with a light. Maybe it's light also, it can be light. An axe is there, or you can say with a short handle, you can say so that was there. And a club. First he uses the hatchet to break upon Buck's crate. That is, crate is that the box which was the wooden, and it was all wooden case. Then he's trying to, that was transported in the train. This was, so he was trying to take it out with that hatchet, and anxious to lose his pent up fury. So anxious to lose up his pent up fury, that is to increase the state of anger. Pent up fury means to increase state of anger. Buck leaps at him and is struck by, and then what it is there? Is being struck by what? By a club. A new and horrible experience he had faced. Then mad fury, what happened? Really became really angry. And then what happened? That drives Buck. But each time, what he does? He rushes the man and he is struck again until he is beaten and bloodied. So he was beaten time and again. He was so violent that he used to again go rush. Again he used to get beaten, and then until he was beaten and bloodied. Morgan, the man in the red sweater, asked him to know his place and be a good dog. Morgan then told him, okay, he was given there, Morgan, be a good dog so that he should not be punished again. And then he patted on his head. So what did he do? Like when we, what happened when something you do something good or something when you do something good, what happens? You are being patted like this. So this is how he was patted on his head and he was given meat and water to drink. So Buck was beaten, not broken. Okay, he was beaten but not broken. What does it mean? It means that he had got setbacks. Okay, he had setbacks but not defeated. Buck was not ready to accept that a man with a club was a lawgiver. So he said, okay, that he was not a lawgiver. So man with a club. So I told you, man with a club was not a lawgiver to be obeyed, even if not loved. Okay, so even if he is not loved, to be obeyed, but they had to stay because, but still, what happens? Though he saw that other dogs, they were what? They were wagging their tails. They were wagging dogs, they were wagging their tails before the man with the club. So he was hanging upon this. Then a Canadian made man named Perrault catches sight of Buck and he believes he is one in a thousand. He was bought for $300. He purchased him along with Curly, was a good natured Newfoundland. He took them to a ship and were taken just to a ship where they were handed over to friend Coyce. Two other dogs joined them. Spitz was friendly. What? And how was Spitz friendly? Spitz was friendly in a cunning way. And Dave seems completely, you can say, disinterest. Was not at all interested in anything what was going around. So, and then ship continued its journey with jerks round the clock. Because they were sent on the ship. And of course, when you go on the ship, so that was the continuous, they were not used to it also. So, they were going on the ship. So, definitely the jerks, you could feel the jerks of the ship. And Buck could feel the weather getting colder and he was not at all used to such kind of weather. So one day when the jerks of the ship stopped, they were brought out on the deck by Francois. So they had to get down, isn't it? By Francois was there, so he had to, they were asked to get down from that this. And Buck first step made his feet sink. Where? This is very interesting. When we come towards the end, it is very interesting also. That Buck, that what happened? You know, first is where his feet is sink into a white, mushy substance. And this, what is this white, mushy substance? Yes. This white, mushy substance. Mushy substance. Here it is. Mushy, here is ice. So, because they were not used to. And Buck was also not used to. So, what he was there? He just, as he puts his feet and it sinks into the white mushy substance that is just like, it's just like a mud, it's like mud. And he, what he did, he licked it cautiously, very carefully, cautiously. Cautiously means very carefully. Cautiously, cautiously, cautiously. What it will be? Carefully. Cautiously, 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 very carefully, and it bit his tongue. So the moment he saw, I mean, he put his feet, of course, there is what he bit, a bit, it bit his tongue, and just like a current, isn't it? Some just like a current, and that was that says that like fire. Like fire, and was gone. It was the first experience of snow. So it was his first experience of snow, and much to the amusement on the onlookers. When we say onlookers, onlookers means spectators, onlookers, onlookers. So who were these onlookers? The people, those who were around there, the spectators. They were the spectators. Spectators, they were the spectators, but it was not to be his last. So after doing this chapter, if you just few questions has already question answer has already been given to you, and revise and learn whatever has been given to you, the question answers based on this chapter.